Welcome to the Weekly Examiner, where we examine this week's top stories. I'm Lisa Rule. Eric Holder, the nation's first black attorney general, announced on Thursday that he will be stepping down from his post as soon as his successor is confirmed. Holder has served as part of the Obama administration for 5.5 years, the fourth longest tenure of any attorney general. President Obama supports Holder's decision to retire and praised the attorney general for all he's accomplished during his time in office, saying he has been relentless against attacks on the Voting Rights Act because no citizen, including our service members, should have to jump through hoops to exercise their most fundamental right. Earlier in the week, President Obama traveled to New York City to attend meetings at the United Nations. On Wednesday, he addressed the UN General Assembly on a range of topics, from the spread of Ebola virus to Russian aggression to the fight against the Islamic State. A notable moment from his speech is when he was speaking on the Islamic State, telling the UN, "The United States of America will work with a broad coalition to dismantle this network of death." Ferguson, Missouri Police Chief Thomas Jackson issued an apology this week to the family of Michael Brown, the unarmed teenager who was shot and killed by a Ferguson police officer in early August. In the video of his apology, Jackson says to the family, "I'm truly sorry for the loss of your son. I'm also sorry that it took so long to remove Michael from the street." Jackson also confirmed that he will not step down from his role as police chief despite calls for his resignation. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention released a report on Tuesday spelling out the worst-case scenario for the spread of Ebola virus without an effective method to contain it. The report predicts that Liberia and Sierra Leone could see about 21,000 cases of Ebola by September 30th and 1.4 million cases by January 20th. But in the best-case scenario, also spelled out in the report, says cases of Ebola could be almost gone in both of those countries by January 20th. Next week, keep your eyes on the newly vacant attorney general position. Look for new names to be thrown into the mix of who will replace Holder. For up-to-the-minute breaking political news, be sure to stay with WashingtonExaminer.com throughout the weekend and check out the latest edition of Washington Examiner magazine on newsstands Monday.